Welcome to the Barbershop Harmony Society's Course Director Development Committee series of educational videos. These videos are designed to give you the tools to lead any group of singers with confidence. Follow the videos in order, do your homework, and you'll be surprised at how quickly you build your skills. Good luck, and remember to have fun. Once the body alignment and breath connection have been properly established, it's now time to move into the third part of warm-up and use the voice. There are countless vocal exercises, called vocalises for short, collections of them in books, websites containing resources, all of them very valuable. In fact, the Harmony Marketplace has a wonderful DVD of warm-up exercises, including video demonstrations, supporting documentation, and it's available for purchase. Even so, a majority of people asked to do warm-ups will lead the group in one of the warm-ups they themselves have already done 1,000 times over. They never stop to ask, why are we doing this? And many times the only reason is because someone they respect did it, and therefore they think they should too. I think the primary problem with vocalises is that the goal of the vocalise, even if it's known by the leader, is way too often kept secret from the singers. You'll do your best at the beginning to clearly identify basic vocal goals and introduce standard vocalises to the group that accomplish those goals. For example, this basic 5-4-3-2-1 exercise can accomplish many goals, but it won't accomplish any of them if the goal isn't articulated to the singers.
We always want to tune to the tonic note. So that high C, play that C again. We want to sing to that C as it keeps going. 5-4-3-2-1. And always listening to the sound we have together with those two notes here. Alright? Let's try that with the drone pitch there. Here we go. And
5.
I exaggerate. 5. It's hard to have a 5 in your sound there. So you want to have a nice, relaxed, open, energized sound. It's in the word 5, it has some life to it. 5. 5. Here it is. And
5.
Exercise 5-4-3-2-1. But we're going to take the words of 5, the number 5-4-3-2-1. We're going to use the word dut and sing them on non-durational dutes. So I'll give you a beat like this, and we're going to go dut, 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 like that. Okay, let's try. 1, 2, ready?
Dut, 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 dut.
Okay, non-durational, don't hold the last one. Let's make sure that dut, there's a couple ways to sing it. You can do it a little more classical-like. You might have to say dut, 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 and aspirate the T there. Let's actually get that T to be part of the next word, the D. So go dut, dut, close it with the tongue. All right? As if you're going to turn on and off the water faucet. Here we go. And
dut, 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 dut.
No hard T. Doot, 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 like that. 1, 2, ready.
Doot, 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 doot.
Yeah. Okay, you need this exercise, okay? So, naturally the phrase 5-4-3-2-1 has a relaxing, releasing feeling. So let's naturally do what the music wants to do. A decrescendo through that. 5-4-3. We'll do it in half notes. Okay. And as we go, we're going to start out nice full volume and get softer as we finish. Okay. And 1 at the end will be a home. Here we go. 1, 2, ready.
5-4-3-2-1.
Very nice.
So, which goals and skills should you set as being the target for your warm-up? As you've just left breath and alignment exercises, it's always a good idea to begin with a vocalese that simply allows the singer to connect the voice to the breath. Following that with a vocalese that allows the singer to explore their range from the highest notes to their lowest notes often works well. Next, move to a vocalese which allows the singers to listen intently to each other to match tone or match tuning or match volume. From there, feel free to branch out into any vocalese that will target any skill you feel the group needs next. One of the most overlooked opportunities is to tie vocalises directly into the skills to be taught immediately following. Some time should be spent in each rehearsal with someone other than the director evaluating the current performance of repertoire, or with an audio of the performance being captured for later evaluation. During a meeting after this, the performance evaluation can be discussed between the primary stakeholders and the group leadership. This meeting could be in person immediately after or before a chapter meeting, or during the week in between. It could also be a conference call, a Skype session, or an exchange of written ideas via email or Google Docs. There really is no end to the possibilities of communication. If you want it to happen, you can find a way to make it happen. Sometimes a skill can't be addressed by a standard vocalese you already know. Or maybe you simply have done the vocalises you currently know to the point where they've lost their impact. In this case, turning to the music itself opens new doors to creating new vocalises which will hit your target skill. All you need to do is select a couple troublesome measures and find a way to lather, rinse, and repeat while focusing on the skill needing attention. Here's a very short sample list of some of the skills that can be introduced and reinforced with virtually any vocalese note pattern. What's most important is that the skill being focused upon is not a just-in-case skill. In other words, we're not doing this as a warm-up just in case we might need to do it in real singing someday. Instead, it should always be a just-in-time skill. We're going to focus on this skill just in time to immediately apply it to our repertoire. Remember, there's no rule which says a vocalese can only be done at the beginning of the night. It can be inserted wherever it's needed at any time. Your homework assignment for this segment is to become intimately familiar with three vocalises. The focus of the first will be to connect the singing voice with the breath. The focus of the second will be to explore the singer's range from the highest notes to the lowest notes. The goal of the third will be to have the singers focus on each other, listening and matching in some way. Again, you can draw on your own experience. You can ask your peers for help, search the internet, or, even better, come up with something completely original. Practice the routine of doing these three vocalises on your own until you feel like you have it comfortably memorized. Next, gather some volunteers and take them through the routine. Listen carefully to what your sample group gives you for feedback on this routine and make adjustments accordingly. And finally, you're ready to volunteer to take your large group through the entire warm-up exercise, physical, breath, and vocal. After you complete the basic homework assignment, we also have an extra credit portion. Meet with your director and explain that you would like to have the opportunity to evaluate a performance of an entire repertoire song from beginning to end. After you complete your evaluation, find time to meet with the director and any other stakeholders who should be involved to introduce to them a skill that you think would help improve that performance. Remember that the skill you choose will not be the only one that needs attention, and explain that you understand that, All you're looking for is consensus that the skill you've chosen is one of those which will help improve the performance. Once you achieve consensus, let the leadership know that you will be developing a brand new warm-up specifically targeting this skill that you would like to introduce the chorus on a specific date. Ask that the schedule for that night be adjusted so that you can introduce this new warm-up immediately before the song that it applies to. When the night comes, clearly explain the goal of the warm-up to the singers without revealing the connection of this warm-up to the song that will follow. Practice the vocalese with the singers until they're demonstrating exceptional skill. At this point, introduce the song the singers are about to perform and explain to them how what they just did applies to the performance of this repertoire song. Step back, allow the director to lead the song, and reevaluate the performance. Good luck, and remember to have fun.